want to welcome you all. Happy Mother's Day to all you beautiful mothers out there. I want to thank you all for being incredible women that you all are. I'm doing this pre-brunch meal. This is what I'm going to eat during the brunch party. So at 12 noon, we have Mr. Brunch Chicago present virtual Mother's Day brunch and day party on Zoom. So go to my page. You want to register? Go ahead and register. I'm about to go ahead and get these meals together. I'm going to listen to some John P. Key. Get my little praise and worship on, and we're going to enjoy ourselves. I'm going to make some homegrown meals real quick. What I'm going to do for brunch, y'all saw me prep the chicken the other day, about to let this thing flow. I'm going to grab the potatoes. I grab big bag of potatoes, so I'm going to grab a few potatoes, and I'm going to shred them up, make my hash brown. You know, I make fresh hash browns, so I have to shred my potatoes and make my hash browns. Name and the things that you broke. Remember that. Come on, just call on God. Call on His name. I'm a music buff. I have to have my music. I need my gospel. So, for two of us, I'm going to do probably three potatoes. I do another small potato. So, potatoes. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead. I'm about to fry this chicken. I got my water already warmed up for my shrimp and grits. So, we're going to get all that stuff going. A little quick hand wash, throw these gloves on. Easy stuff you can make at home yourself, man. What's up, Lionel Martin? Hey, Neve, what's going on, Destiny? Send my Mother's Day love to everybody over there, all my sisters and my family over there. Come on, Brother Lionel. So, if you saw the episode on Friday, I was prepping. I deboned my chicken thighs and made my buttermilk marinade from a fried chicken. So I've just prepped my grease. So I actually prepped my grease and put a little something in my grease so I can have that flavor. And the reason that I debone it, you know, it doesn't take that long to fry. So it's an easy and quick fry. And get a bowl of them. I got one here. Yep, I got one here. Quick waffle. So, quick meal. We done probably less than a half hour. Everything I need to do. So, I have pre-marinated chicken. My chicken already pre-marinated. What's going on, Erston? Hey, happy Mother's Day, Andrea. Happy Mother's Day to all you mothers. Soon-to-be mothers. Expecting mothers. Happy Mother's Day to you all. You earn this day. You earn this day. And I'm just going, I'm putting it bag in bag. Buttermilk, I'm doing two. Ziploc bag. I'm going to shake a Ziploc bag first, put it in the pan today. I'm going to go ahead and just get it done quick. Give me a little air. Flour is already seasoned, so I told people, you know, you season your flour to your discretion, how you want your flour seasoned. But I season my own flour the way I like it, so, you know, it's already pre-seasoned, ready to go. I dropped that chicken, she's ready to go. Evenly coated. if that's supposed to be here. We are the victory. We are victorious. I dare you to lift your hand. Shake off the excess flour that you don't want. I can shake off the bag. I drop that chicken in there. Nice, crisp toast. That's frying for like 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Probably 2.5 minutes. Really about 3 minutes from the time I initially drop it. I keep my eyes on it. It takes no time to cook this shit. No time. Got one more. We're not gonna eat that many. Just the two of us, so. I drop another. And this is going back in the fridge. So my grits, my water's to a boil. What's up, Carl? What's up, Miss Sanchez? And I got my water to a boil, so pretty much like 3 cups of water. And then I'm going with a third cup of grits, quick grits. So I don't fill it all the way because I do another rinse of probably about another cup. Remaining grit residue, and I pour back in there. Perfect, right on time. Also, you know, I flavor my grease. I put flavor in the grease. Like I use fresh herbs with my grease. So that's just a little trick that I use, especially when I'm cooking a fried chicken for competition. As you can see, nice and crispy, golden brown, cooked chicken. I mean, right there, man. Mouth-watering chicken. It's your boy. That's how I get at. You know, I can only be me. Gotta be me. You know? So... gotta do the chicken up right, you know what I'm saying? Make that thing good for everybody. So that's how I get out of the kitchen. I gotta have my music going. You know, I might sing a song or two. You know, so right now I'm getting my gospel on. And get ready for this next phase. So. Put the grits. Cook down. Grits cook down. I'm gonna make my roux for the shrimp and grits. So let me get me a little spices out of here. Onion, a little obey. I'm definitely using my onion, celery. So come on, here we go. I'm gonna use a little Cajun Creole and celery salt, you look at that. Come back with this little seafood oil seasoning. So I'm gonna use a seafood seasoning. Let's go. I'm making seafood. So. There you go. We come back. Another piece of this chicken, this grease. Hey, yeah, shake it. That's it. You just put it in the bag and just, you know, use your bag, shake up your chicken. Take it out. You know, it's fully covered. Shake off the loose part that you don't need. Let that chicken sit in there, let it fry. That chicken should be ready in 3 minutes. Golden brown and crispy. Just like this, golden brown and crispy. I want you to see the result. How your boy get out on that chicken. What's up, Jeff Murray? Yeah, this is how your boy get out on that chicken. Crispy. I'm cooking it right in front of you, dog. I don't play. I get out in this kitchen. You know what I'm saying? I was raised by some of the best in this thing. And then, you know, I just learned from the professional aspect of actually working in food service. So, you know, boy, I get at you. I get at you in this kitchen. So I'm making all of this. And all this food is going to be prepared before this brunch it off. All right, now we're going to start up these grits. I'm going to let this thing simmer, put it on this simmer low. Let it simmer low real quick. I still want to get a little thick. And the reason being, I want the grit to look thick because when I put that roux in there, it's going to loosen up. You know what I'm saying? So, we definitely start that. Matter of fact, I'm gonna use this for the roux. If I brought this one out. So, let me rinse it real quick. I'm gonna use this pan for my roux. Turn that over. Let that continue to fry. Like I said, I got 45 minutes on there. I may add another minute or so, but no more than 3-4 minutes. It take you to cook those chicken thighs. That's why I debone them the way I do. Taking all that meat. Hey, Tina Jackson, what's up, D-Bird? And that's why I debone them, so it doesn't take me that long to fry them. Big crispy pieces of chicken, ready and flavorful, ready to go. throwing this cold water. That's why I'm using the spray mold on these potatoes. I'm coming back. I'm about to shred these up so I can make some fresh hash browns. All about this multitasking. All multitasking. All I'm doing, multitasking. So it's telling me that, what, this fried chicken ready. Just about. Let's cook on this side just a little longer. Give me another 2 minutes. Probably when that minute's down, I'm gonna go ahead and take it out, but. Let me praise you now. Come on. In the sight of the praise. Hey. Let me praise you. Hey. Let me praise you now. Hey. And it's time to give you. So I got something praising for. I could have been sick. I could have been down and out. I could have had COVID, been in the hospital on a respirator. But God kept me. Woo! He kept me. I'm still here with y'all. I'm just making my seasoning for my little roux. Little old baked seasoning. Not even really a teaspoon, so I'm just sprinkling it in here. So I got seasoning. I got celery salt, Creole seasoning, old bay, onion powder, little seafood seasoning. On there. Now my chicken is ready. I'm gonna cook nice and golden brown on both sides. The girlfriend's ready. Turn that off. Look at that chicken, man. Look at that chicken. Tell me that boy not fried some chicken right there. See that chicken right there? You see that? You see what I'm dealing with right there? That's what I'm working with. Bring it out to you. Fresh and crispy, man. That's how I do it. Get out. That's that award-winning chicken right there. That's that award-winning. That's them thighs. Deboned, man. Poof. Coming out quick, flavorful. All right, so coming back, we're ready to make this quick shrimp and grit roux. I'm gonna have a cream right now. Green light. Ooh, there we go. Snake would have bit me. Heavy cream. So I always want to start with that heavy cream, y'all. So start with that heavy cream. This little Creole seasoning that I mixed together, I'm dropping that in there. and I'm stirring that in with my heavy cream. Real easy. Stir that up, that heavy cream. Heavy cream do its thing. Eating it up. Come with some mango nectar. Just give me a different little flavor. That's all. Give me a different little flavor. And some waffle. Easy waffle mix. Not a multitask. One egg. Ain't nothing but just, you know, already boxed pancake mix. I'm gonna use that. A little oil. It out some, so you don't want no runny shrimp and grits. You know what I'm saying? What's up, Andre? What's up, Phil? Hey, Keisha, what's happening? Devo Robinson, what's going on, brother? Hey, tell my sister, Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, all you beautiful moms out there, man. Happy Mother's Day for all the beautiful moms out there today. Today is your day. So. Water. I got my oil in there, I got my egg, and I'm just making it. Ain't nothing but regular pancake batter. I'm gonna add something to it. You sure enough right. So I'm coming with some honey. Got my honey out already. Mango neck on both sides. Yep. That's some honey. You can use brown sugar too, but try to keep it as natural as I possibly can. I'm just whipping it up. I'm whipping it up with a little spoon. That's it. Whipping it up with a little spoon. Don't take a whole lot, man. You got to spend a whole lot of money. You got some good food. And there it is. I'm mixing this thing up with this little spoon right here. Mixing it up. Woo, 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 woo. There it is. There it is. Mixing it up. Thank you. shrimps and the roux is coming together. I can smell the flavor. And the thing is, I love the shrimps already cooked, so it's not much you really have to do to it. So I'm just pretty much letting it warm up in the sauce. Now I let the sauce come to like a real heated boil, a real minimum boil, if that. Because you don't want to, you know, re-cook or overcook these already cooked shrimp. You want the shrimp to stay nice, keep their size. You just kind of want to warm it up now with the roux. Like I said, it's thinning out. So it's already thinning out the roux. So you're good to go on that. And like I say, just use your nice heavy cream, you know, heavy whipping cream. Go with that. Throw your seasons in there. And, you know, add whatever, you know, juice, spice, or whatever marinade you want to add, or mango nectar, fruit nectar, and, you know, just rock and roll from there with it. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to shred these potatoes for the hash brown. So, I like my potatoes freshly shredded. Don't take any time to do it, man. No time. Don't take no time to do this. You know? Just knowing the process and just applying. That's it. Application. Get done. Copies. Now you can do the frozen hash brown, you know, that's up to you. I just don't do the frozen hash brown. You know, I like my stuff nice and fresh. You don't have to try to peel the whole thing, get yourself enough. It's actually enough for us. So this is enough for two. Yeah, just gonna make a nice 2.5 pounds. Not too much, just enough. Put it in the colander, I'm gonna rest it. Cold water. Let it sit. Rinse it real good. Cold water. I leave the skin on it. Always more flavor, so that's just me. French fries, anything with potatoes, I'm leaving the skin on it. So, yeah. You want peeled potato, knock stuff out. So now this has come to a nice simmer boil. So now, come on over here. And this type of boil like this. Nice little simmer boil. That's what you want. Just a nice little simmer boil on there. Ooh, I have to smell it. I smell it. It smells delicious. Get a ladle. Throw that a ladle. I got them grits, nice and tight, whip, just as thick as I want them. Stir it in. You want to see how much more roux you want to add for that thickness, because I said it's going to break it down. So. Ooh, man, look at that right there. Whisk these two out.
Black truck, your black, what you got?
This stuff is good. Look, come on, do you lie? Are you for sure? Who do you lie? Are you for sure?
You know, I'm gonna know the shrimp. We eat some shrimp.
Are you for sure? Who do you lie? Are you for sure? But why? And so you can see, that's some shrimps in there with the shrimp and grits steaming. You can see the shrimp in there, the roux. I was able to loosen it up, so that's a nice consistency for me for those shrimp and grits. Coming back, olive oil in. Do you feel my olive oil?
And I heard a voice say, what mother had to do for the reason the sky is blue. What do I have to give? I'm so thank
you, man. What do I have to say? Something like the day. Is it me? Is it me? Got my wings good. Ain't it stuck? Kids up getting bloody. But I'm waiting for you to try to bring that. What you gonna do? What am I gonna do? Instead of school, what they should have been doing. This fight is gonna hurt. Some other practice.
Hey, what's up, Mickey? Uzi, what's happening? Linda Red, happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, all you beautiful ladies out there. Yes, happy Mother's Day. Let's in here making something quick. So I'm about to make these fresh hash browns. I got the chicken ready. I got the shrimp and grits, so I'm going to start plating so you all can see. I'm not doing too much. I'm going to do the waffles and all, but hey, I got the waffle mix.
I'm the reason the sky is blue.
Matter of fact, let me go get this waffle iron. And quick step, we'll get the waffle iron. We'll go ahead and do that.
I'm so sad. What do I have to say? I'm a son that likes the day.
Quit me. Yep. Walk right in the other cooler closet. Clean, ready to go. Before we put them up, make sure they clean. Who do you love? So I pan it. Lay it down. Lights will come on when it's green, it's ready to go. So we're good on that.
Is it me? Is it me? Nobody. Who do you love? Who do you love? Are you for sure? Who do you love? For sure, who do you love?
Is it me?
Nobody. Who do you love?
That's right. Praise and worship. Love God. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. We're just about done, ladies. We're just about done with this Happy Mother's Day brunch that I'm making for you ladies. Make it for Jerry. You get that right. Making it for Jerry. So we're almost done. So, cover my hash brown. So, I got an audible on. I'm just making a quick little patty. And you see, nothing but a quick, making a round patty for this hash brown. You can scatter it if you want, but I'm just gonna make a round patty so I can make it quick and easy. I have my olive oil on there, so that's cooking. And then I'm just kind of straight salt and pepper and a little basil. That's it. Salt it. Pepper. Yep. Need that again, and that's a little basil. We're gonna let that cook just like that. Clean this ladle off. I can use that. Watch that real good. I have the shrimp stuff on that, so I have to watch that. And walk around is going to let you know when it's ready, because the green light's going to hit and say you're ready. So, it's your boy. No, I'm not down to 225 yet. I'm still 250, but hey, I'm doing better every day. You know what I'm saying? So, still sweat up a little bit, but hey, I'm losing weight versus gain. Alright, so now it's ready. Turn green. I got a ladle. Sit there, cook that bottom portion going, and then close it up. Start cooking on top. Flip it. And green light to come on and let me know when she's done. So we're done with that. Aspect of chicken waffle. Hash brown, so I'll flip it with a hash brown. Opposite side, pepper, salt, basil. I wanna say I would do anything just for a day. Shoot, just for a day. So it's praise and worship hour. Just about finished. I'm about to show you the finished product. Once this waffle come out. It's almost done, so let me plate everything else that I have right now. Let's get the chicken out there. Let's get the grits on the plate. Nice, big, beautiful piece of chicken. Come on, man. Come on, you don't get no better than that, boy. I'm talking about that's good, beautiful fried chicken right there. But I wonder if you hear me. My way. side.
Did you know that you were the reason I live my life? Lord, I would give anything to see you.
Just for a day.
Just for a day.
Just for a day.
Oh, 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 yeah.
And I just wanna know you.
It, man, that Mother's Day meal, there it is. It's less than 45 minutes. I gotta get ready for the day party. You got your waffles, you got your hash browns, the hash brown over there, you got your hash browns, you got your shrimp and grits, you got that fire fried chicken, man. Fire fried chicken. This your boy, Mr. Brunch Chicago. This is how I get down, man. It don't take a whole lot. I'm gonna tell you that. It don't take a whole lot. So this is how I get down in the kitchen, man. Getting ready for the day party. TC Martin, good to see you. Sharon, what's up, sister? Everybody, thank y'all for coming in, chiming in. Appreciate y'all come check me out, man. This is the finished result. Finished product. That slamming, jamming fried chicken right there, man. Them shrimp and grits. Come on now. You can't buy nothing better than that. Them fresh homemade hash browns. Waffles, man. Homemade. It is a honey mango waffle. I'm telling you, this your boy. Mr. Brunch Chicago, we get down in the crib like this, man. Check y'all out. See you at the Brunch Day Party. Make sure you go to my page to register RSVP so you can go immediately to the party, man. DJ Mello coming up at 12 noon. DJ Mello is popping that thing off 12 noon. Mr. Brunch Chicago, y'all.